In this video, we are going to learn how to vacuum an AC unit using a manifold gauge. First, let's understand why we perform a vacuuming process. Vacuuming is done when installing a new AC unit or after performing maintenance work on the indoor unit. By vacuuming, we can remove moisture, air, and non-condensable gases from the coil. These gases can significantly affect the performance of the AC unit, so it is crucial to remove them. Additionally, vacuuming helps detect any leaks in the unit. Now, let's see how to vacuum an AC unit. The two essential pieces of equipment required for this process: a vacuum pump, a manifold gauge. We can also use a micron gauge for this process. With a micron gauge, we can get more accurate readings. If you would like a video on how to vacuum using a micron gauge, let me know in the comments and I'll prepare and upload that video. In this video, we will use only the manifold gauge. When installing a new unit, the refrigerant is typically pumped down and stored in the outdoor unit. Similarly, when performing maintenance work on the indoor unit, the refrigerant is pumped down and stored in the outdoor unit. We have already explained how to perform a pump down process in a previous video. You can find the link to that video in the description and the first comment. Check it out if needed. First, as always, make sure to wear the necessary safety PPEs. Before starting the work, turn off the unit. Next, connect the yellow hose of the manifold gauge to the vacuum pump and the low pressure side hose to the suction line of the unit. In this process, we will use only the low pressure side gauge and won't use the high pressure side gauge. Once both hoses are connected, turn on the vacuum pump and open the valve in the gauge. The pump will start removing all the non-condensable gases from the evaporator and coil. As air and gas are removed, the pressure on the gauge will gradually decrease. We can vacuum for 15 to 20 minutes. During this process, the pressure on the gauge will reach -30 psi. After 20 minutes, close the gauge valve and turn off the vacuum pump. After turning it off, wait for some time and check if the pressure on the gauge increases. If there's a leak in the coil, air will enter through the leak, causing the pressure on the gauge to rise. If the leak is very small, it may take more time for the pressure to increase. The longer you wait, the more accurately you can confirm whether there's a leak. If the pressure doesn't increase, it means there's no leak in the coil. Once you confirm there's no leak, use a hex key to open the suction line valve. After fully opening the suction line valve, open the discharge line valve as well. This will allow the refrigerant stored in the outdoor unit to flow completely through the indoor unit and coil. Finally, remove the manifold gauge from the unit and then start the unit. This completes the vacuuming process for an AC unit. In the next video, we'll learn how to charge refrigerant after the vacuuming process. If you found this video useful, please like it and share it with anyone who might benefit from it. If you have any questions about this video, leave a comment in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our Zebra Learnings channel. Thank you.